So thanks for joining the session. So I will just give you how we build a successful DevOps culture at Cisco. As a start, just a few words about me. So I'm currently a SRE manager at Cisco within the Emerging Technologies and Incubation Business Unit. So what I really do like is really new technologies, open source, innovation, collaboration, and DevOps. Otherwise, I will not be there. What I'm used to do as a starting point is that really shares a quote from Walter Savage, because in theory, there is no difference between theory and practice, but in practice, there is. So that's really important for me to share experience returns about what we've done in Cisco, and so no really theory nor bullshit in this talk. The agenda will be really simple, so starting from a few words about what is and what is not DevOps, what makes a strong culture, and also a few tips about how to make a strong culture within your enterprise that we are doing at Cisco. So no surprising. So as you saw in this conference with Patrick Dubois, which is really the pioneer of DevOps, this is really about breaking the barriers between Dev and Ops. So nothing new for you. Based on and there is the camps you might all see, which is about culture, automate, measure, and share. And I will be really focused on the first point, which is about culture. And also, just as an extension, I will say DevOps is really about optimizing the world, not only about dev and ops, but within an enterprise, you need to consider also the business. So taking 10 years ago, where we tried to think about moving to cloud, this was a huge impact with sales. So that's where you need to also include the sales in the loop. HR people also are key with regard to the culture, but also the people who are working with you in your team, such as management, and also the last trends since 2 years with regard to security. So everyone in the same team, all working together. So that's why, for me, DevOps is about culture and people, and nothing else matters, I would say. And I want to say that this is not about a team being a DevOps team, or this is not a job nor a role, and there is no DevOps tool as per se. And we used to hear DevSecOps, NetDevOps, NetOps, SecOps. Okay, why not? But just for me, this should be already included in DevOps. So for example, DevSecOps is really key with regard to all the cyber attack we've seen so far. And it's really important, but so security teams should be involved as soon as possible in your process or in your team, whatever happened, and this is still DevOps. And NetDevOps also, like we used to say in Cisco, for example, so this is just about implementing DevOps in the network, which is not kind of easy because this is not fully in the cloud, for example. Anyway, so let's move on the key element is that what makes a strong culture. For me and at Cisco, really, our focus is really on about two pillars, I would say. This is really about collaboration and sharing. So maybe easy, but then how to make this happen? For me, you need to bring people together. So I know that there is a sanity crisis at the moment, so this should not be in person, but it's really hard to do it at the moment in person. But we are really stronger together. So that's why we leverage events to bring people together in conferences, hackathon, summit, or conferences. So you've got conferences like this one today, which is really useful in order to discuss DevOps. Everyone brings something. So this is really what we used to have in terms of formats. But what we bring at Cisco was really a focus with unconference and hackathon, which I will describe just now. Why unconference? For me, this is really one of the best formats to foster the collaboration between your teams, between your business unit, and between your company. Especially when you've got big companies with a lot of silos, this is really a useful event. And why? Because this is really a participant-driven meeting. open and informal, and the principle is easy, free events, and you just need to bring either a contribution or a need. Also, like on our day-to-day job, you need some principles, so and only one rule, which is the law of two feet. Sorry. So if you are not learning or contributing, let's move to another session. So this is really open, and also people that are currently on a session, if there is someone leaving, that's not an issue as per the principle, because whoever comes is the right people. Whenever it starts, it's the right time. If you've got a lot of discussion, this is good, because in really a big company and day-to-day job, it's really hard to find time to discuss with other people not in your team or not in your department. And whatever happens, it's the only thing that could have happened. And also, when it's over, it's over. It's not really mandatory to stay in a session that you are not contributing as per the first rule. And so do not waste your time. Time is really key. A little of history before jumping really in the deeper details and to give you the background. So we start the DevOps at Cisco community launch in 2013. Starting with some sharing session, virtual sharing session in September. And at that time, so it only starts with four people. So Reinhard, Will, Frank, and myself. And we really think that having virtual session was not really useful. And we were thinking about having events to bring people together. So that's why we start in 2014. In San Jose with the first end conferences, and we try to make it a regular habit. So every year we try to bring a lot of people to all together. So we target around between 100 and 200 people per conference, and not too big a conference because this is hard to manage. Also you need budgets. And after 2017, we moved to more local events, to really bring more dynamicity per region. And also we move to other events like hackathon or summit, focused really on the technologies or area of interest, so just as cloud summit, etc. Again, so then what's the format of a conference? So it can take multiple days, so from 1 day to 3 days we've done so far. It's good to like conference to start with a good opening and a keynote. We try to bring at that time, because we were 10 years ago, we were more really a hardware company and we were shifting to the software world. So we try to bring key people on that area, such as Damon Edward or John Willis, or people like Garrett or Amy, focus either on with a strong interest around DevOps, so in working in Puppet or in GitHub. And so you start with the keynote, and after you've got two different sessions, short one around lightning talks, and after the open space, which is the main session of on conference. Just a few words about lightning talks. So we do like talks because it's just a good way to present a topic, but we decided to make it short, starting first by it, so that you get to know someone and you get details about one topic. And as this, the full event is really informal, you've got many times to discuss deeper with the people presenting the talk later on the day. And then here is the main, the core principle and the core format of the end conference is about open space. And this is laid by the attendees and for attendees, which is really key, because you want to be there to contribute or to learn something. And we start with an empty schedule. So you will see that we've got a full board with just post-it. And then people brings, you will see on the right picture that they come one by one saying, take the mic, I want to discuss that at that time on this room. And then other people think, I want to join this session, bringing another idea, etc. And then within 30 minutes, you've got your schedule for the conference. And then comes the open space. So open space is really a room dedicated to discussion. So you will see on the picture that Everyone is more than welcome. You just have two people that take notes and also recap the session to be shared and later on the events. And then whatever happened, it happened. So, and this is really useful to have really the time to discuss with colleagues because we are not used to, if you're on a project, you've got a delivery, et cetera, and you've got formal process to do your day-to-day job. But having the time to step back to discuss with your colleague is really, really key to move the collaboration forward. Last but not least, as you might know, what is also key is the lunch and dinner, because breaking barriers and silo come with about people. And then, as you can see on the left picture, in the US, we try to bring everyone to a typical US restaurant. And it was a way to really have a lot of informal discussion with people just after the conference, taking time to know each other, like also with a lunch with a lot of people from India sharing about their culture, etc. And that's really key for me. And also, that's why you should leverage this kind of format. Not at the moment, sorry, again, with the sanity crisis, but... And that was not it, at least, because what we try also to add by the time, because like in DevOps, where you've got continuous improvement, we always try to bring more things. Before the end conference, we try to bring also trainings. This is good also to have the time to learn from our new technologies or tool, but the culture first again. And after also just to keep the energy on, we try also to do some hackathon and workshop. And so end conference was good. This is really good to break the silos, as I said, but this is not the only recipe to make good things. So that's why we are running also on a regular basis hackathon. So hackathon can be 1 day or 2 day events where you hack with developer on something. So breaking barriers start internally. So we've got internal hackathon that we run on a regular basis. And that was good also to challenge the people, to bring again a lot of different teams together to work on a dedicated topic. So that was working well. We did at least around 12 seasons in San Francisco running every year. And also with some focus on the region to have local challenges. We also do a lot of hackathon as per DevNet initiative. So I'm not sure most of you knows, but we currently have a DevNet platform where we expose all our product API and our open source contribution. So that was also a public hackathon. And as we used to share to people or to the open source community, we share also to nonprofit, as you can see on the right top right picture, where we run Hackathon for Good. So this is also part of our strong culture at Cisco. Then here is the last point about my presentation, which is about corporate culture. And why this is key. I really think that we need a safe and great place to work. And as an example, at Cisco, this is not about having HR. This is just about having people and community where we push conscious culture. Especially in the engineering, this is good to have really diversity and inclusion. This is really good to have different people coming from different countries, sharing different views, different culture. And this makes really unique and something that is good also to keep people working on your team. And that's where also the management and your day-to-day job is good. And just to reflect on that, just to give you more details about our principle, and we really try as manager or leader to apply it on a day-to-day job. So give your best always with your colleague. Just give your ego a day off, because whatever is your position at Cisco, just do not care. We are all here to work together, and also try to give something or yourself to your colleagues. And this is the best way to have a great team working all together. the text difference to Earth is really the way to work all together. And I will tell just two examples of how it is currently applied. So we've got, for example, one platform which is named Living at Cisco. This is where we try to make the appreciation habit. So this was also a good initiative launched by collaborators and also with the support of our people and communities team. And this is where you just say thanks to your colleagues. So you give a token based on the six previous principles I've listed. So you pass a token and tell you thank you for what you've done so far, or whatever. And then the token goes to another person, and then it gives back $1 to a not-profit organization. And also that was really useful to see that token were passed all over the world. And that was really well appreciated by all the colleagues. And this is just about saying thanks. We never say enough thanks to people. And another tool, the last example, we've got also connective recognition. So again, this is by collaborator for collaborator. When you really work with your peer on a dedicated topic and you want to thank them, then you connect it well and you give them money. So you've got different level of recognition that you can attribute to your peers. Without especially manager approval, but that was really again for our collaborators, and that was really really a good exercise. And then after, so I talk about a lot about culture, but this is not really the only thing, but I would say the third thing to put first. But after, you need to really to consider continuous improvements, not only about your solution but also about your teams. Again, try to put the people first and make sure that you are continuous. You have got continuous improvement with regard to training or just attending this kind of event on a regular basis. Try to automate everything. Everything is source control management, so infra as code, etc. But that's the next thing. But just the takeaways for a successful DevOps culture, I would say, just try to have a strong corporate culture, just to have a safe place to speak, a great place to work. Collaboration and sharing, for me, is really the strong pillar of a DevOps culture. And then after the culture, you can be focused then on your tools, tooling, on your automation, make sure you've got everything fully tested in your automate pipeline, security also everywhere. You can deliver container for sure, having a SaaS, but with strong security is quite key. And I think I'm done for now. And so we think we have time for question now.
Yes, now we have a question time. So do we have any interesting questions popped up now?
There's one here that I can already, I pulled through a little bit. So. Jeremy, question, what kind of project have you worked on in hackathons and how do you organize a good hackathon?
Yeah, organize a good hackathon. So that's a good question. So hackathon, so internally, we did run a different set of hackathon, some on security, some just to do innovation and break silo. And we've run also a lot of external hackathon, and it depends really on how you want to put it. But what we've done so far, we are doing workshop 1 week prior the hackathon. We've got everyone thinking about the challenges, getting to know about the team and also all the tech used for the hackathon. And then after we run, I would say, 2 days hackathon, and you've got the last the award at the end of the hackathon. But yeah, the workshop is quite key to be able to pitch your ideas to meet the people that will work on the event itself before running the hackathon, because it runs fast. You've got a lot of work to be done with the developers, designer, etc. So it goes really fast.
Right.
All right. Yes, we have another question here. It's Tony. He wonders if you have tried unconference during the COVID time online.
That's good. So, and no, unfortunately not, because we stopped the unconference 5 years ago to go to a more local local type of events. And yeah, I know COVID and this sanity crisis does not help, and it will not work online. It could, but it's really hard because even if you've got the best virtual tools to have good meeting online, it's not like that in-person meeting. For me, in-person is really the only way to break the silo and to discuss culture and people. And yeah, I would say that, yeah, keep the online event for now just to stay safe. And this will end soon, for sure. So just try to, you can make online events, not as unconference format with open space, you know, because yeah, virtual meeting is not like in-person meeting. Just be patient. We will be back in a kind of normal mode soon. I hope so.
Yeah. So we have another question, that is, what kind of metrics does Cisco use at the value streams, or examples of metrics that Cisco uses in general, and what tools for monitoring? It's Roberto who want to know that.
So as you can see in the DevOps principle, you've got the measure part, which is a key element to implement continuous improvements. So metric is a key. So for the unconference, we take a lot of feedbacks from the attendees just to make sure that we target our objective, and also we improve the unconference by the time. So it was really survey. Survey is kind of mandatory for anything you're doing at Cisco or anything you do it on a regular basis. So survey for hackathon, survey on conference like this one, you will have a survey for sure. So give your feedback also, because this is the only way to improve anything you're doing. And in terms of monitoring, so what we measure for the end conference was how many attendees we've got so far. And at the beginning, we saw that we've got, I would say, more developers than operation teams, security team, and we've got no sales. So we try to include more people by the time. That was also one feedback we have, and also what we measure as a something. And after, what you can monitor, I would say what we monitor at Cisco is the contribution to open source, for example, or things like that. So try to get as much metric as you can, because this is the key value that will also help you improving the way you are currently working.
All right, thank you. And do we have any other questions which we have missed out on?
Yes. What frequency does the company organize all these hackathons and everything else? Can you give any thoughts on that? This is from Samantha.
Yeah, so thanks for this question. So yeah, this is a really good question also too. If we were in an ideal world, I would say as much as we can, but there's still the budget question. So because this was a grassroots initiative, so we had to fund budget in Cisco. Mm-hmm. And so it was not so hard, because we've got a lot of support for executive. We tried to make it on a one per year for the unconference. It was enough, because we try also to do other event at the same time. So we were one unconference per year, one hackathon per year, and also cloud summit, security summit, this kind of event on regular. And considering that you've got different events that you need to run, you should not have too much event, because yeah, you still need to be focused on your day-to-day job, which is about working. Yeah. On your team. So this like this conference is good, but you see that there is plenty of DevOps conference. Try to attend not too much, but some good ones, and try to not be try to keep the focus on your teams too. So that's good.
Thank you, Jeremy, and for the audience. This was not paid advertising. It was a real comment from Jeremy. This is one of the best DevOps conferences out there. Anything else, Ragnar?
No, I think we have covered the questions in the chat now. If I'm not missing anything, I've tried to scroll through everything now. So we have actually a couple of minutes left, I think, for questions. If someone has something on their mind, just type in the chat and we will give it to Jeremy.
Yeah, maybe the last. I mean, is this the first time that you participate at the DevOps conference organized by us?
Yeah. So this is the third one. I did with you guys. I'm used to also do a DevOps talk more in France, I would say. I did some conference. Also, I spend a lot of time internally because, as you know, Cisco was an hardware company and we were shifting to the software. Mm-hmm. So that's why it requires a lot of work internally to really bring this culture up. But as we are really now more mature, I'm currently, but I'm not the only one that are currently giving DevOps talk. And so you might see more people in Cisco doing DevOps talk, and also we've got also a lot of cloud native conference where we participate in. That's where you will see there is no magic. So you bring people all together, you shift to the software, and then we've got more people doing technical talks on key areas such as cloud native, which is I would say the main DevOps focus.
Very good.
Okay, Jeremy, do you have any other social media platforms which you have presented this kind of information on? I'm thinking of perhaps YouTube and so on. Have you touched this area in some talks in other areas?
I'm not sure I got your point, but so I give a lot of talks. I try to push them on the social media, but yeah, I've been running also a lot of other conferences, which was in person too. But at the moment, due to the sanity crisis, I did not do much talk. I was more focused internally and also try to deliver more stuff fight this crisis.
Maybe one more last question. There is from Igor Soroka. How the DevOps culture has changed during the COVID times in Cisco?
I would say I was really surprised to see that. I was thinking that, we were kind of stuck and it will, so this sanity crisis will have a big impact in Cisco. But that was really, I was really surprised to see everyone working more closely, even if we cannot meet in person. So, everyone just made more efforts at Cisco, either working with non-profit, because for me, this is also the key pillar to be able to give back to the world. And so we've got a lot of initiative internally to contribute back to nonprofit to help organization fighting this crisis. Mm-hmm. We've got also Cisco offering most of their solution to be able to work online because it was mandatory to work online. So and we also try to have free offer on the security because most of the company during the sanity crisis get cyber attacks, and that's really a pain because but that's the way the work. So you can see that we were really present. We tried to find a solution to really help enterprise not paying the product they purchase not today and just leave them the time just to try to work. And to pay their employees and so a lot of initiative. This is well described. You can check on online. You will see that our executive team have made really good efforts on trying to fight this crisis all together. So that was really nice. And everyone is involved, not only the executive, because this is also a key element. This is good to have an executive sponsor, but you will see that a lot of people get involved to add their contribution. So that's a good.
All right. Thank you, Jeremy. And also a big thanks for Maddie Stratton here on the chat. There was a question that what does unconference have to do with the DevOps? And Maddie pretty straightforwardly answered to that question. Well, DevOps came out of the unconferences. So there you have it. Thank you very much, Jeremy. Merci beaucoup. Excuse my French pronunciation, probably not the best, trying my best. But thank you very much indeed.